Very good evening, one and all. Welcome to India's largest live learning platform, GradeUp. सही प्रेप है तो लाइव सेट है, GradeUp है तो सही प्रेप है. So guys, stick to GradeUp. A warm welcome to my series, practice series, and warm welcome to the session. Quickly join the session and mark your presence. Today we will practice 30 questions in 50 minutes from which subject? Computer networks. So today is C&A. So guys, quickly join the session and mark your presence. Ishan, good evening. So guys, this is a regular boring slide for you. A brief introduction about me. I am Satya with all the other credentials. You can just find my details if you want. And guys, on GradeUp app, every branch Gate Champion contest is happening. If I talk about computer science, on Monday, Wednesday and Friday, this contest will happen. And on every Sunday, there will be mega quiz. And tomorrow's mega quiz, I am taking. And the topic is trees and arrays. So without fail, join this mega contest tomorrow at 7 p.m. exclusively for GradeUp app users. So if you have not downloaded it, please download. And this is the Mega Mock Challenge details for the June month. Today we have this Operating Systems Mega Mock Challenge, and the next Mega Mock Challenge, which is for the NEET aspirants, that is on 16th June. So keep attending all the challenges, guys. And there is 50% off on super subscription to support this pandemic situation. Your economic situation, we understand. So GradeUp is offering 50% off to support your preparation in this pandemic, guys. To avail this offer, use the code HOPE50, and this offer is very limited. So hurry up and take this subscription. Okay, so without wasting much of your time, let me start the session with first question is here. If a selected CSMA CD network takes half of the time than usual transmission delay, 4 times that of usual propagation delay, then the relation between them can be expressed as, let T1 and T2 be the resultant transmission and propagation delays. So guys, give your answer. What is the answer for the question number 1? Ishan, Raja, Rajput and everybody, give your answers in the chat box. And also keep liking, keep sharing. Please share this session. Let many people join the session, guys. So what is the answer for this question? Option C is the right answer. How? For a CSMA CD network, we know transmission delay is greater than or equal to 2 times that of propagation delay. So given TD is 1 by 2T T1, and that is greater than or equal to 2 into 4 times that of T2. So here T1 is greater than or equal to, T1 by 2 is greater than or equal to 8 T2. So T1 is greater than or equal to 16 T2. So option C. Good, good. Prateek, Soni, Rupali, Srivastava, Raja Rajput. Very good. Next question. Consider a network that uses CSMA by CD. If two stations X and Y are attempting transmissions in such a way that X won the first back-off race, Y won the second back-off race, let the probabilities for winning in the next attempt be P1 and P2. Then P1 equals to what? What is the relation between P1 and P2? Hurry up. What is the answer for the question number 2? X won the first back-off race, Y won the second back-off race. Option B, okay? But the right answer is option C. Why? X won the first back-off race, so X sent its packet, let's say P1, successfully. Why need to win the second back-off race? So Y sent its packet PA successfully. Now X has failed in sending P2. X has failed in sending P2. Now PB and P2 are giving the attempt at a time. So X is sending its P2, Y is sending its PB. Collide. Now X will choose any number from 0 to 2 square minus 1. Y will choose sending the probabilities any number from 0 to 1. So what are the probabilities? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 2, 0, 2, 1, 3, 0, 3, 1. So guys, 0, 0 is collision, 1, 1 is collision, right? Now, this is X, this is Y. What is X probability to win the race? Only 1 among 8. What is Y probability to win the race? 5. So P1 is 1 by 8, P2 is 5 by 8. So we can say P2 is equals to 5 times of P1. Got it? Next question. IEEE 802.4 follows dash topology physically and dash topology logically. Very easy question. Give your answer for the third question, guys. Very easy question. And also, please do share it. Guys, if I need to present the next questions and if I need to take the sessions like this, you need to share and bring more audience, because when more and more students come, more competition is there, then only the session would go in a next level, right? So question number 3, the answer is option B, because if you see token bus, this is how we connect the stations. The token will be passed from higher station to lower station in the ring manner. Whoever acquired the token, they will only do the transmission. So logically it follow ring topology, but physically it is connected in the bus topology. Okay, next question. In an Ethernet network, if the actual data to be sent is 30 bytes, the sent packet includes dash bytes of padding. The actual data is 30 bytes. Then the sent packet includes dash bytes of padding. Hurry up. Kavita, Pratik, Raja, Rajput. All the others. Fourth question C. Okay. We know that the minimum header length is 64 bytes. In this 64 bytes, you will have payload as well as header. Sorry, minimum packet length. So there will be payload and header and tailor together. Header and tailor together, if you see, there will be 18 bytes of header and tailor. So what is the max payload you can put? 46 bytes. But we have only 30 bytes. So how much padding will be added? 16 bytes padding will be added. Okay, so the right answer is no doubt option C. Yes, good, good. Next question. Let the sender node A wants to send a file of size 5000 bits using packet size 2500 bits to station B through intermediate node C using the capacity 100 kbps. Propagation delay is 20 milliseconds between every two nodes. Then the total time to send file is. Hurry up, what is the answer for fifth question? So we have A, C, B. Pratik Soni, 64. Okay. See guys, the total time is, we can say, I will give you the shortcut. This is the total time for one packet plus remaining packets transmission delay. Janavi, option C. Okay, let's see. So what is the total time for one packet? At A it has to be transmitted, A to C propagated, at C transmitted, C to B propagated. It is given propagation delay is 20 milliseconds. And what is the transmission delay? Packet size by bandwidth, which is 2500 by 100 kbps. So this is 2500 by 100 into 10 cube bits per second. So here you will get seconds. So this is 25 milliseconds. So what is total time for one packet? 25 plus 20 plus 25 plus 20. This is 50 plus 40, 90 milliseconds plus remaining packets. How many are remaining packets? When the file is 5000, one packet size is 2500, only one packet is there, its transmission delay is 25 milliseconds. So this is 90 plus 25, 115 milliseconds. Okay. So the right answer is option B. Next question. Let the total time to send a file of size 10,000 bits through two intermediate routers is 360 milliseconds. Let the packet size is 2000 bits and bandwidth of each channel is 50 kilobits per second. Assume the length 200 meters, propagation speed 10 kilometers per second. If each intermediate node holds a packet for t time, then t equals to what? What is t? Quick, we are just in 6th question, we have more 24 questions and already 16 minutes is over. Come on, hurry up. So guys, it is using the same formula. First you find the total time for one packet plus total how many packets, guys? When the packet size is 2000, total file is 10,000, 5 packets. Guys, please confirm my visibility and audibility. There is power issue, so I have just connected through my UPS and all. So guys, let's see how long we can take it. Okay. So it is using the same formula. If you go ahead, you will get the time as 10 milliseconds. Okay. 10 milliseconds you will get. Now, let's see the next question. Question number 7. An IP datagram of size 1000 bytes arrives at a router. The router has to forward this packet on a link whose MTU is 100 bytes. Assume that header size is 20 bytes. Then the number of fragments that IP datagram will be divided into. Guys, some students have left, so please do share it. Ask them to rejoin. So 7th question, yes, option C, because in 1000 bytes we have header 20 bytes, so in every packet, so in MTU payload will be there, payload 80 bytes will be there and 20 bytes header will be there. So out of 1000 bytes, how many packets? 13 packets minimum, right? Next question. A sender uses stop and wait ARQ protocol for reliable transmission. Frames are of size 1000 bytes. Transmission rate is 80 kbps. Size of acknowledgement is 100 bytes and transmission rate of receiver is 8 kbps. The one-way propagation delay is 100 milliseconds. If no frame is lost, what is the sender's throughput? Hurry up. It's a previous gate question. Janavi, please use the question number, Janavi. The right answer is option B, because you will get the transmission delay of sender receiver, propagation delay of sender receiver we have got as 100 100 100 for everything if you calculate. So this is completely 400 milliseconds and we want throughput. In this much time, how much a sender can send in one stop and wait? One frame. So 1000 bytes in 400 milliseconds. But we want in bytes per second. So you will get 2500 bytes in 1 second. Okay. Next question. Consider the source computer S transmitting file of size 10 power 6 bits to destination D over a network of two routers R1 and R2 and three links L1, L2, L3. L1 connects to R1, L2 connects R1 to R2, L3 connects R2 to D. Each link length is 100 kilometers. If the signal travel at 10 raised to 8 meters per second, the link bandwidth is 1 Mbps and the file is broken down into 1000 packets. So what is the total sum of TD and PD for transmitting the file? Again, it is total time for one packet plus remaining packets, how many? 1999 packets transmission delay. Total time for one packet would be 6 milliseconds. If you count all intermediate nodes TD, PD, 6 plus 999 into 1 millisecond. So this would be 1005 milliseconds. Option A is right answer. Good, good. Very good, guys. Now, question number 10. How many hosts per subnet in this given IP? Tenth question C. Wow. Let us see the answer. Yes, the right answer is option C. We have slash 24. That means 8 bits are there for host ID. So total number of hosts will be 2 raised to 8 minus 2. Why minus 2? First and last. This is 256 minus 2, 254. Good. Next question. Consider class B network with IP address so and so. The number of subnets and number of hosts per subnet would be. Tell me. Question number 11. Answer is. I And guys, please share it, bring more students. I want to see at least 30. For 30 questions, at least 30 should be there, no? So at least 30 students should watch it. So Raja Rajput, Pratik, Janavi, Mariappan, all the others, YouTube gamers, Kavita, please share it and bring more audience. Okay. Yes, what is the answer for this question? 11. It is option C. Option C. Number of subnets, number of hosts per subnet. So slash 20 means 12 bits for host ID. So 2 power 12 minus 2 hosts per subnet. Okay. Now class B. So 16 bits for the network ID. So remaining bits will be 4 bits will be for subnet ID. So total subnets means 2 raised to 4 minus 2, 16 minus 2. So 14 subnets, 4094 subnets, host per subnet. Okay. Next question, easy question. Intra-network and inter-network communications. No, no, Pratik, Raja Rajput. Even the first subnet and the last subnet IDs we use in the same way for host. Like it is just understand. Suno beta, Pratik Soni, Raja Rajput, Suno beta. First host ID we will use for network interface, right? Subnet interface. Last host ID broadcast. Broadcast in the subnet. In the same way, for the first subnet ID we will use for the common network interface which connect all these subnets. Okay. And the last subnet ID we use for broadcasting among all the subnets. So two subnet IDs we will leave. Okay. Okay. So intra network communication, within the network we use MAC address and between the networks IP address. So it is MAC comma IP. Okay. Next question. Consider 500 class A networks are organized into 10 groups of 50 networks. The subnet mask used by the interface should be. The subnet mask used by the interface. So here we don't want number of subnets and all. We just want subnet mask. Whether it is first or last, subnet mask will be there, no? So what is that? And do like it, share it, and subscribe to our Grade Up Gate channel, guys. The right answer is option A. Because we say class A, 8 bits for the network ID, and we have 10 groups we have. So 4 bits for the subnet ID. So leaving this, total 12 bits once in mask. So that would be 255.240.0. Next, the subnet ID of the given IP address in binary. In binary is. Question number 14. What is the subnet ID of this IP address? The right answer is option B. See, 172, this belongs to class C. Class B. So in class B, these two represent network ID. So more 4 bits. So 152 in binary, you take 128, 16, 144, 8. 152. So this is 152. Here these 4 bits represent subnet ID and the rest bits represent host ID. So what is subnet ID? 1001. Okay. Next question. What is the last host address of the network? So and so. Last host address. Guys, I want everyone's involvement. This is the competition, so you have to be quick enough and accurate enough. So don't get demotivated. Keep liking, keep sharing, keep giving the answers. Hurry up. The right answer is option C, because here slash 27 we have, so leaving 27 bits, remaining 5 bits we will change. So 196 will be like this, 140 will be like this, 130 will be like this, 110 if you convert into binary, 64, 32, 96, 96, 8. 104, 108, 110. This is 110 binary. Here, this will be as it is, and for the last IP, this becomes ones. So this is last IP address, which is 196.140.130.127, last IP. But we know last IP is used for broadcast purpose. We want last host address, so last but one, that would be 196.140.130.126 is last host address. Okay, next question. Before that, let me introduce our courses, Vision 2022 in both English and Hindi medium, and Vision 2023 in both English and Hindi medium batches enrollment started, and very soon we are closing the enrollments for these batches. And you can find the highlights, 850 plus hours of live classes, practice questions, many more mock tests. You can see what you will get in every course. So hurry up and take this super subscription. Now there is 50% off on super subscription, guys. So take it and enjoy all the courses. And if you have any doubts or for any further information, you can call us on this number 965005204 and talk to our counselors. Take the super subscription. Okay. And we are the team of computer science faculty. All are very well experienced, knowledgeable persons, trained GATE students since many years. So guys, you will definitely get the quality education through our faculty team. So no need to hesitate, hurry up and take the super subscription. Okay. Question number 16, which is not private IP address? Which is not private IP address? Straight question, guys. Pratik Sori says option C. Kundeti Kala says option C. Jahnavi. Okay. Let us see. The right answer is yes, of course, option C, because these are the private IP addresses range 172.16.31 only, but it is beyond that. So it is option C, no doubt. Next, the broadcast address of second subnet in a network with address so and so is. Second subnet with address. Option B. Yes, of course, option B. So keep 26 bits constant and what is the last address remaining 6 bits, you see? So 200.100.200.10000.0 1010. Here keep 26 bits constant, these bits will be constant and these bits will be ones, and here 00 is first, 01 is second, so 200.100.200.01, so this is 200.100.200.127. Okay, next question. Suppose a node with IP address so and so wants to send a packet to itself, then what would be source and destination IP address fields? What is your answer for question number 18? If any wants to send to itself, what would be source IP, what would be destination IP? Yes, it's a straight question. The destination IP would be loopback IP, having the source IP as it is. Right. Next question. If there are 64 frames to send, then N designates dash for sender window in GBN scheme. In go back N scheme, what does N stands for if total we have 64 frames to send? N always says sender window size, capital N. What is the sender window size in go back N? 2 raised to small n minus 1. If there are 64 frames total, how many bits? 6 bits. So what is this? 2 power 6 minus 1, 63. So the right answer is option D. Okay. Next question. Suppose sender A sends a message to receiver B in 200 milliseconds transmission delay and 100 milliseconds propagation delay. Then utilization under stop and wait scheme is. Under stop and wait scheme, what is the utilization? What is utilization formula? W by 1 plus 2A. Here W means 1. A means propagation delay by transmission delay. Propagation delay is directly given, transmission delay is also given. So it is 100 by 200, 1 by 2. Okay. Now U is equal to 1 by 1 plus 2 into 1 by 2. This is 1 by 2, 50%. So the right answer is option B. Yes, good. Next question. Consider the following specifications. The minimum number of bits for sequencing the frames is. Very good, guys. Keep going. I appreciate Raja Rajput, Pratik Soni, Jahnavi, especially you three people, because you are keep giving the answers. Very good. That's the spirit. And also bring more students, guys, because if many people get benefited out of these free classes, we also will be more happy, because if it reach out many students, then that would be I can say justification for this kind of free sessions, right? So that is in your hands, how well you justify by liking, by sharing. So quickly share it, guys. And if you are pursuing your academics, bring all your class students, your classmates here, because it is fun while attending these competitions, and also it would be learning, right? You can enjoy while learning. So what is the right answer? Option B. Again, the same formula, W by 1 plus 2A. Here what is go back and window size? 2 raised to n minus 1. A is propagation delay by transmission delay. What is propagation delay? Length by speed, transmission delay, packet size by bandwidth. So just substitute, and we are looking for small n. So small n, you will get 4, minimum bits 4. Next question. Consider the CRC polynomial x cube plus x plus 1 to send 1100101. Then what is, how this data is transmitted as? Quickly solve it, guys. It's in fact a previous gate question. So x cube plus x plus 1, this means what? 1, x square 0, x power 1, x power 0. 1011 is the divisor. So we add how many zeros to the dividend? 3 zeros. So you do XOR procedure. By borrowing the bits. So here you can borrow 2 bits because there are. Like this, if you follow, finally you will be getting 010 remainder. You just do it. So what you will get? Option B. Okay, you will get option B, Raja Rajput. Check it once. Next question. Let sender X wants to send a message at 6 frames to receiver Y with window size just 2. If every third packet gets lost from X to Y, but no acknowledgement gets lost, then total number of packets transmitted by X to send entire message is. So question number 23, Jahnvi, option is C. What about others? Pratik Soni, Ankita Gaikwad, Nishu Kumar. Nishu, you said you are eagerly waiting, but why you did not come till now? What happened, Nishu? The right answer is option A. Because we know we just have 6 frames and every third packet gets lost. So frame 1 goes off, goes safe, frame 2 also goes safe, frame 3 gets lost, so we just realize that after sending frame 4, so this gets delivered, frame 3 we will retransmit, now it goes safe because it is not the third packet. Now you will send frame 5, but it gets lost, but by that time you will send frame 6 also. Now you will retransmit frame 5. That's it. Total 6 packets gets delivered. So total 8 packets you need to send to transmit 6 frames using selective repeat. Okay. Next question. Which is false about BEB algorithm? Quickly read the options and give your answer for question number 24. BEB algorithm, what is the false statement? The right answer is option C. One persistent CSMA does not follow BEB algorithm. Only non-persistent and P-persistent CSMA follow BEB algorithm. So this is false. All the other are true. Okay. Next question. In an Ethernet local area network, which one of the following statements is true? This is previous gate question. It's option D. Because this is previous gate question, I don't think explanation is needed for it. Next, Consider an IPv4 datagram with a header length 40 bytes. If payload of 400 bytes has an offset 325, then sequence numbers of first and last bytes of the datagram would be. Question number 26, answer please. What you are asking, Janavi? I did not get you. Question number 25 you are asking. See, station stops to sense, that is definitely false. Purpose of jamming signal is not to pad because of small size, that is preamble. Jamming signal purpose is to avoid collisions, not preamble. That padding is different. Jamming signal purpose is not to satisfy minimum frame length, so that is false. And station continue transmitting even after the collision is detected? No, it retransmits the frames. That's why. Okay. Exponential, definitely BEB algorithm reduces probability of collisions. Okay, question number 26 answer is what? Option B. Yes, yes. So we have 400 bytes payload and header length is 40 bytes. So we have offset 325 bytes. Offset is 325. So 325 into 8 is the actual sequence number, that is 2600. And how much payload we have? 400 bytes. So 2999. Straight question. Just to confuse you, it is given header length. Next question. The application layer protocols are based on dash transport layer protocols respectively. HTTPS, TFTP, FTP, HTTP. So these application layer protocols are based on what transport layer protocols? Yes, of course, all are based TCP based, but TFTP, Trivial File Transfer Protocol, is UDP based. Next question. Which of the following is or not a type of registered port numbers? Registered port numbers, which are not registered port numbers? Do you know? The right answer is option A, option D. Because 0 to 1024 are well known port numbers. 49151 are registered port numbers. Remaining 49152265535 are dynamic or private port numbers. So 16535, 32786 are in the range. The other are not. That's why they are not registered port numbers. Okay. Next question. If the IPv4 header starts with so and so, then the header length is dash bytes. The header length is dash. Here 4 says version 4. E says HELEN. So what is E? 14. So what is header length? HELEN multiplied by 4. So that is 14 into 4, 56 bytes. Okay. Last question of the day. Assume source S and destination D are connected through two routers R1, R2. Determine how many times the packet visit layer 5 to layer 1 respectively. So application layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, physical layer. Last question, guys. What is your answer for question number 30? Yes, very good. The right answer is except application and transport layers, remaining layers will be covered more than twice. Network layer will be covered 4 times. These two will be covered 6 times. We know the this is how we can represent this. Right? So how many times each layer is visited, it is clearly understandable. That's all for the day. So what is your score out of 30? Pratik Soni, 27 out of 30, very good. What about others? So identify your mistakes and the reason also. And I believe these sessions are helping out to increase your speed. Yes or no? I believe so. So keep attending, keep sharing it. So let many friends, many of our students benefit out of this session. Even if they missed live, at least they will watch recorded. So guys, I request you guys to keep this YouTube class link in your Facebook, WhatsApp, Insta, Telegram, everywhere. Okay. And these are the free series taken by our star faculty in this June month. So starting with 11 a.m. till 8:30 p.m. you have one or the other series by our faculty. So keep attending these live classes. If you have not downloaded GradeUp app yet, please download and start attending these free classes. And if I talk about my series, my series name is Abhyas series on GradeUp app at 8:30 p.m. on these dates. If you have missed live class, you can attend or you can watch the recorded one, guys, don't worry. And these are completely free classes. And the next class is trees and graphs practice. So mark your alarm, set your alarm and attend the class. That's all for today. On Monday we will see If you don't have any peer group for preparation, how to be motivated? Generally, it's a common tendency that you will be looking for the peers for preparation. So, how you can self-motivate if you don't have any peer group? I'll tell you. So, see you on Monday at 8:30 p.m. on Greater Pap. And these are our 2021 achievers. 100 plus rankers we have under top 100 and 10 plus students we have under top 10. So hurry up and take super subscription now at 50% off. The offer will be very limited and access all the structured live courses. Before you leave, don't forget to like the session, share it and subscribe to our Grade Up Gate channel. Thank you so much for joining the session, guys. I hope you enjoyed it and this session helped you a lot. Thank you so much. Good night, guys. See you. Bye-bye. Stay home. Stay safe.